I'll tell you what it'll take for Utah State. It'll take a second-half comeback. They trail by 12 as you look at the first-half numbers. And the turnovers, 9 for the Aggies, leading to 14 points off turnovers. Back courtside with Steve Lapis. I'm Andrew Catalan. We'll hear from Evan Washburn in a minute, but we said the frenetic pace that New Mexico plays with on defense, Utah State handled it early, not so much later in that first half.
The first 10 minutes were completely different. They only had 2 turnovers. Then all of a sudden, the last 10 minutes, and I don't know if they got worn out mentally, physically, 2 games in 2 days, but Utah State really struggled. 8 turnovers in the latter part of the first half, and that really turned the game around. And actually, when New Mexico is doing that, they start playing much better on offense because they're getting some layups and doing some things. And here they're just making you go out of control. And that's what Utah State is having trouble dealing with now, is being aggressive but being under control at the same time. That's hard to do when you're a little fatigued.
Let's go over to Evan Washburn.
Well, Tim Duryea said aggressive is the thing they lost in the final 8 minutes of that first half. He said it's as bad as we've played in a portion of a half this season. As for the second half here and trying to get back into this game, he's going to start 4 guards. The idea being generate more passing, try and generate some more shots. It's all about motion to try to fight that pace of New Mexico.
Well, I like the thought, because the big thing about that is you're going to have more ball handlers on the floor, so more guys can attack the pressure and deal with the pressure. I think that's a good move going with the 4 guards.
Utah State shot just 34% in the first half and 3 of 12 from deep. It's New Mexico ball to start the second half. They're 20 minutes away from playing San Diego State in the Mountain West Championship game, and Furstinger adds 2 more.
Well, that's what you got to worry about, too, is their ability to be able to go inside, even though Furstinger did take Quinn, he took Quinn Taylor, who is the one big guy in the game for Utah State.
From an Aggie perspective, they did trail at the half in each of their first 2 Mountain West tournament games and came back to win those 2. They'll need to do it again tonight in the semis, but Lockwood fouled hard. I'm not sure how they missed that one on the other end.
That was a complete layup that ended up not getting even close to the basket. Something had to happen.
Quinn Taylor just picked up his 3rd foul. And Lockwood, who led the Lobos with 10 points in the first half, is back at the free throw line.
I don't think anybody has been able to dictate the pace on New Mexico for a while.
Longest win streak of the season for the Lobos, 6 in a row. And during this streak, they have averaged 96 points per game. Over 100 twice in the last 6 games. McEwen step back jumper, tough shot. Furstinger grabs it and pulls it up ahead. He'll hand off to McNeil.
Layup.
Extra pass. McNeil. 3 is good.
That's just really, really good basketball.
An 18-point New Mexico lead. And Merrill is fouled. That's going to go on Antonio Jackson.
Well, you take a look here. A good back cut is how it starts, but the extra pass from Kuiper. What a beautiful way to play this game, I'll tell you. These guys share it, they play together, and McNeil just knocks it out.
They average 16 assists per game, which is 3rd best in the Mountain West.
And that play that you just saw down there, they have tremendous chemistry right now. That's why they're winning all these games. The chemistry is on point.
Knocked away by Jackson. Lockwood the other way.
Antonio Jackson, he is really tough defensively.
Furstinger, another tough 2 for Big Joe. He's got 8 points, and Utah State calls timeout. An 8-0 run to start the second half for New Mexico, and they have pushed the lead to 20. Paul, we're in the low. Broncos have pushed their lead to 20 in the Mountain West semifinals. As we get an eye on the Mountain West, brought to you by Wall. San Diego State earlier tonight defeating Nevada to advance to the Mountain West title game for the fourth time in the last 5 years. All five starters for the Aztecs had at least 11 points, with Devin Watson leading the charge with 20, in New Mexico hoping to get into the championship game and win the title for the fifth time. Looking good right now in this one.
Anthony Jackson has that ball up the court in 3 seconds. It was at 27, the shot clock, when he was at the top of the key.
After the Brown bucket, makes it 45-27. He's been tough. And the foul for Sam Lockwood.
They have nobody that can guard him. Too strong, too athletic. Very good with two or three bounces. That's all he needs. Two bounces and a spin, and he's at the basket.
Kobe McEwen just picked up his third foul, and Lockwood completes the three-point play.
Lockwood is very tough on that ball, on that inbounds.
Brown corner, McEwen. And that three is good for Kobe McEwen, who had missed his first 4 3-point attempts tonight. The lead remains 18,
and they're going to try that zone again.
Jackson will take that three. And the high rebound to Brown, and a foul inside on Lockwood. That'll be the second, and the senior out of Indianapolis. Here's another player like Anthony Mathis that thought after the coaching change in the offseason he would transfer, but had some meetings with Paul Weir, liked what he heard, and decided to stay. Now the two of them did not see eye to eye for a while this season, when Lockwood missed 7 straight games in January, partly because of a shoulder injury, but also because of a disciplinary infraction that Weir held him out. But Lockwood is back, and a big part of this 6-game win streak for the Lobos. They ended the first half on a 20-3 run, and they've started this half on a 12-5 run. And the ball just ran over your monitor.
And don't think for a second, Andrew, that those, what he did discipline-wise, that those two kids didn't bring this entire team together and create the chemistry they have now. It absolutely did.
I think what Weir has done since day one in Albuquerque is try to build a culture. He wanted to change not only the way they played on the court, but how they handled themselves off the court. And there were some tough decisions he made this year, and here they are about to go to the Mountain West Championship game.
You don't do it this way, you can't be part of the program. That's it. We do it one way, and it's my way. That's what we need to do.
Simons' three pushes the lead to 21.
How about Merrill in this game, Andrew? You know how many shots he's taken? 5. Yeah. I mean, he can't get a shot off in the last 10 minutes of this game.
He had 10 points 6-7 minutes in, and he still has 10 points.
It's pretty hard to score if you can't get shots. Great pass.
Now watch the one-handed jam.
And you know what else you see from these kids? Andrew, they're having fun. You just see it.
Brito missed it. And this is just snowballed on the Aggies.
Kind of out of nowhere.
That's travel. A timeout with 15:21 to go. Mukwach Malawach has had a couple of highlight reel dunks. Another one right here as you're watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota. ...53-30 in favor of New Mexico here in the second half of Mountain West semifinal number 2. As we check back in with our principal financial game plan, Steve.
Yeah, limit live ball turnovers. That hasn't worked out so well. 16 points off turnovers for New Mexico. The M&M boys started out pretty good, but not really lately. High possession game. Lobos have been all over this. They've been on the offensive glass a little bit, but they've been pushing the ball. There have been a lot of possessions in this game. And transition threes, 5 for 15. New Mexico's game plan working out a little bit better than Utah State.
Perry straight ahead with the left hand, and he is fouled. This half, Utah State is 2 for 8 from the floor. And for the game, they're shooting just 32%.
And that's after starting the game in the first 5 minutes, shooting very well.
Perry at the free throw line. He missed 16 games this year with calf and ankle injuries. He missed all of November, was able to return, then missed all of January. He's played well here in the last couple of games. Season high 14 against Colorado State in the first round, and 3 of 3 from deep for 9 points in the win over Boise State for Julian Perry, the senior out of McKinney, Texas. Mathis wide open. Offensive rebound, Logwood, and he's fouled inside. And he was the fourth offensive rebound for Logwood.
He went up and snatched that thing with two hands. And I'll say this, Mathis is one of the best three-point shooters in the Mountain West Conference. Can't be more open than this. Look at that. I mean,
Mathis was in double figures every single Mountain West game. 18, as he stepped out of bounds, 18 straight games he was in double figures until last night against Wyoming. He was held to 8 points. And tonight, Mathis again, 0 for 2, has not scored.
Just not really involved in the game. He had a wide open one there. You can't get a better shot than that.
Brown in the corner, deflected by Mathis. He got a hand on that one.
And he was wide open, and Mathis just ran that down so hard. That's what happens when you're giving a tremendous effort.
Simons just inside the line, halfway down and out. And Merrill still with 10 points. Finally, he's able to take a shot, and he lays it in. Just the sixth field goal attempt of the night from Merrill, who's the team's leading scorer at better than 16 points per game. Logwood, ooh, he missed it down low. And Utah State has it with 13:45 to play.
Merrill looking to drive it and be more aggressive. That's a good pass.
And Taylor finishes. And Paul Weir wants a timeout. 6 straight points for Utah State.
I like what Merrill has chosen to do here in these last couple of possessions. Put the ball on the floor and see if you can make something happen with the dribble. He drove it once and scored. He drove it once and dished for a layup.
We do want to thank our entire CBS Sports Network crew, producer Ken Mack, director Jim Cornell. And again, the championship game will be on CBS tomorrow at 6 Eastern. Well, make sure to tune into the 2018 Reese's College All-Star Game on March 30th, live right here on CBS Sports Network. You're doing that game.
I will be there.
What about Evan?
Evan, I don't know. I think he's off. Was he off? Isn't he off today? No, I'm sorry. He's here.
Wow. Oh, I'll be out there, guys, and I'm going to fly in class, Lapis. Yeah. How about you?
He's funny, this
guy.
Oh,
I put that one on a tee, didn't I? Looking forward to that. The Final Four in San Antonio this year.
Great place for a Final Four. One of my favorite.
Yeah, you love it.
Oh, I love it. The Riverwalk is tremendous.
Go,
You just go on that river walk and you see everybody. Good pass.
Perry inside.
Sure, I'll make that.
Perry gets it back. Off line. Now on the scramble on the ground. Possession arrow in favor of Utah State.
Well, these kids are getting after. I mean, Perry's got to make that shot initially. And good hustle there.
There's Brito back in as Perry goes out.
Hey, keep talking.
Can you handle, can you go like 10 possessions in a row without turning the ball over and without getting sped up? That's the hard part for Utah State. Now they're in a pretty good groove again.
And Furstinger's foul, trying to throw that one down. Well, they called that foul.
On the ground.
Tom Brito.
He was laying in the basket.
Yeah.
Trying to dunk it.
So instead, New Mexico will inbound. New Mexico has not scored in 3 minutes and 20 seconds. And a foul is called inside on Utah State. It'll be their fifth team foul here in the second half as Henson is whistled. Third foul. Make it the second foul on Deron Henson. Neal all the way back to Simons.
It's interesting what happens in New Mexico when they go through a period where they're not wreaking havoc, like now.
Simons cuts to the middle. Furstinger, off balance shot is good, and Tim Duryea looking for a travel there, doesn't get it. Big bucket for Furstinger. That stops the run and the steal. Simons up and he's fouled. And Brown just slammed the basketball. He's got to be careful there. Dwayne Brown could have been called for a technical. Instead, Merrill picks up his third. .55-39 in the Mountain West semis. New Mexico has the lead. The winner will see San Diego State in tomorrow's championship game on CBS. The New Mexico bench tonight outscoring Utah State 17-3. This on the heels of what the Lobos did to Wyoming yesterday with their bench outscoring the Cowboys by 30 in that game.
Well, that happens on a regular basis with them because he basically looks at eight guys. I'd say Pinchuk is the ninth right now. He's been going a little bit more with eight. Pinchuk not playing as much, but those eight guys, any five could be in the game at any time.
You are watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota on CBS Sports Network.
You know, Andrew, we were just talking about Utah State doing a better job. Then all of a sudden, there's a score, a press, steal, two foul shots. And you know, the hardest thing about playing against this style, you don't practice against it ever. It's hard to simulate it in practice. You know what we would do when teams pressed like this? We'd play 7 against 5 in practice as much as we could.
Yeah.
We'd have 7 guys playing against the 5 regulars. Just try and simulate it as best you can.
Taylor spins down low for two. Nice move to the post by Quinn Taylor, the junior from Houston. Firstinger. Man, he's got that shot mastered on the glass.
You know, I mean, we've watched this guy for years. Score two, score four. Now he's got 10 in this game already.
Brito in the corner. Brown ran into Logwood, and that's a foul on Logwood.
Well, let's take a look. You see, Joe Firstinger is right there. You see him here. Just hanging around. Nothing special. The penetration is what created the basket.
The foul on Logwood is his third. Firstinger with a dozen to go along with six rebounds. There's Perry connecting from deep. Julian Perry.
He's finishing up his career on a high note. Yeah. He played very well here.
No question. He's got nine tonight, had nine last night, and 14 against Colorado State on Wednesday. Steal by Perry. McNeil is back. Perry right at him, and he missed it, but McEwen cleans it up. 59-46, midway point of the second half.
Good hustle by McEwen there.
Do the Aggies have something left in the tank to make a run?
They got to try and dig down for one run.
Alawach.
And one.
And the foul. Every time you think maybe Utah State can make a run, New Mexico has an answer.
Well, this was a bad pass by Firstinger that Perry reads very well. McEwen on the finish, and then Malwatch with a nice spin move in the lane. And one.
Malwatch, born in Sudan, but grew up in Sydney, Australia. He signed with New Mexico in July. He was recruited by associate head coach Chris Harriman. And when Chris Harriman told Paul Weir, you know, we got this guy in Australia I think we should take a look at, Paul Weir gave him a call, and McQuatch said, I'm sorry, I don't have time to talk to you. I gotta go to work. He's a groundskeeper. And he said, I gotta go to work. It's time for work. I'll talk to you another time. And Paul Weir said, that's the kind of guy I want. I want a blue collar guy that was working, didn't have time to talk. He had to go to, didn't want to be late for work. Those are the players I want in my program. And this guy has really improved throughout his season.
Unbelievable. I had a game, and I had their first game of the year, one of their first games of the year in November in Florida, in the Emerald Coast Classic against TCU. They played great that game, but they had TCU on the ropes. They could have won the game. And this kid here was not very good that night. And every time I saw him after that, he got better and better and better.
Now averaging 9.8 points per game in just 19 minutes per game.
You know, it's funny, when they lost to TCU that night by two, I was like, oh, this is a great, great job. I mean, for these guys to be this close with what they had coming back, that's great. They've gotten to be pretty good.
Trying to lock up their seventh consecutive victory. Malawach again.
Tough shot. Strong move. Really strong.
He's got 9 points to go along with three rebounds. Perry off glass for two. 30 of New Mexico's 64 points have come in the paint.
You watch, Andrew, after a basket, the ball is up the court. There's 27 left on the shot clock. There, the ball is up the court at the top of the key in 3 seconds every time. That's a charge. I thought he hooked it.
Instead, it's on Utah State and a 1-1 for New Mexico. Fouls on Brown.
Yeah, I'd say that's an offensive foul.
Logwood in double figures for the 15th time this season, but he misses the front end of the 1-1. McEwen short.
I'll tell you the other thing I'm impressed with Andrew in New Mexico, these guys are in pretty good shape.
Yeah, that's a great point.
They're pretty good shape. They don't look like they get tired. They're playing only eight guys. They're not playing 10, 11. They're playing eight. And they look pretty conditioned to me.
Let's go over to Evan.
One way they keep them conditioned, you both have been to the pit. Under Paul Weir, part of the conditioning test, and this has been gradual. They got to run the stairs up and down of that bowl-like arena in under 6 minutes.
Oh, wow. Hey, I'm annoyed when I got to go to the bathroom at the pit, and I got to walk up those stairs. I'd like them to send a cart for me.
Takes you 6 minutes to get up the ramp. Could have said when you go to get a bite to eat.
Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. But no, I don't have to walk up the stairs to get a bite. I can wait to get a bite to eat. It's a little different. Sorry about that, folks.
That's all right. It's late. There's Logwood again at the line with 8:19 to go in the second half.
And I'm sure the height, the mile high city that it is, has something to do with the oxygen too, and them being in shape.
A very tough place to play. They've gotten used to it, obviously. Great home court advantage.
Yeah, that altitude can get you. Now they're playing a little zone. They haven't played much zone in two games. But look, this is not a regular zone. It's pretty aggressive.
Perry with five on the shot clock, and Perry from the baseline. He's got 13 points. Mathis is still scoreless tonight. Their leading scorer. There's Mathis with the shot clock at four. He puts up a deep three. Merrill, the touch pass to Brito. A one-timer. Merrill to Brito. The lead is 13 with 7 minutes to go. Erstinger and Kuiper at the scorer's table set to check in for New Mexico. Simons for three. And again, the Lobos have an answer.
Anthony Jackson driving into the lane, kicking it out into the perimeter.
Simons has a game-high 17 points. Merrill's pass deflected. Here comes Simons. And McEwen knocks it out of bounds. It'll be New Mexico basketball when we come back. 69-53. Lobos looking for a spot in the title game. Time for the cut above the rest, brought to you by Steel Sam Logwood. He's got 16 points for the Lobos to go along with six rebounds, and four of those six rebounds on the offensive glass, he has all of New Mexico's offensive rebounds tonight.
He's been terrific tonight. They just haven't been able to deal with his physicality, his athleticism, and he's been really tough on Utah State. But you know what? In this New Mexico, it's just his turn tonight. Last night, it's Erstinger. When that game we had against San Diego State, it was Anthony Jackson. I mean, it changes every game.
Kuiper hits it close. Thank you. 17 points.
I love the way he uses his body on the drive. Look at this shot.
I don't think, Paul, we were like that one with the shot clock at 26. McEwen's pass high. Brito saves it, but now it's Simons and a foul.
That's a good call.
And it's on Simons.
That's a good call. They better be careful. I believe that was a good call. Take a look here. Well, I thought I saw him push him. Maybe not.
A lot of boos from the Lobo fans here at the Thomas and Mack Center in Las Vegas. It's the third foul on Troy Simons, who leads all scorers tonight with 17. Tied with Merrill, who also has 17 for the Aggies. Perry, offensive foul.
Yeah, he stuck his leg out.
Foul number three, Julian Perry. First time that Utah State has made it to the semifinals of the Mountain West Conference Tournament. They have not won a conference title since 2011 when they were in the WAC.
What a great left hand by Furstinger.
He's got 14 points and 6 rebounds tonight.
He's headed for the all-tournament team.
Simons grabs the miss by Perry. Now Jackson will slow things down. Offensive foul on Antonio Jackson as Taylor draws it. Well, the two games that Utah State played against New Mexico this season, the Aggies shot 52% from deep. But tonight, Utah State 6 of 20 from beyond the arc. They're the type of team that's going to need to hit 10, 11 threes. And it's not happening tonight.
Because they're not getting much inside. They don't really have a post scorer at all.
Erstinger off a great feed from Jackson, and he is fouled. Anthony Jackson in Mountain West play leads an assist per game, 5.8. Furstinger, though, has had the hot hand again.
Boy, he's got a really soft touch in terms of using that glass. Really, really good doing that. He's got a great left hand. Smart player. Knows what he can do and what he can't do.
6 of 7 from the floor tonight. And a chance to add to his point total from the free throw line.
One of the best attributes a player can have, Andrew, is knowing what he can and can't do. The guys who try to do things they can't do, they look bad. The guys who stay away from the things they can't do, look good.
Big hand for Furstinger as he comes out.
He doesn't want his senior season to end.
Exactly what he said at the podium last night after the win over Wyoming.
This is the most fun this kid's probably ever had playing ball.
There's a foul in the perimeter. That's on Chris McNeil, 1-1 for Utah State. McEwen was the first top 100 recruit to ever sign with the Aggies. So, big conference offers, and liked what Tim Duryea had to say, liked Logan, and to his credit, said, I knew I could come here and play right away. And that's That's exactly what he did last year, the Mountain West Freshman of the Year. And this season, averaging 15 points per game. Travel by McNeil. 3:56 to go. New Mexico up by 16.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Wall, the brand used by professionals. Visit wallgrooming.com.
Coming up next, CBS Sports Network brings you more Maction with the second semifinal between Eastern Michigan and Toledo. It's Bracket Week presented by Kubota on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports, Buffalo defeating Kent State earlier. Here in Las Vegas, 3:56 to go in the Mountain West semifinals. New Mexico with a 75-59 lead on Utah State. On the verge of advancing to the championship game against rival San Diego State. Merrill in the corner. And a whistle inside. That's going to go on the Lobos and send Utah State to the free throw line. Third foul on Malawach, and here's Quinn Taylor. He's 4 of 4 tonight for 8 points. Scary incident earlier this season with Taylor. Did not play in the game against Wyoming because of a heart issue. His heart rate got sped up. He was taken to the emergency room and shot back into rhythm. And only missed one game, failed to return, and has not looked back, so we're happy to see that.
Was there a lane violation?
Yes, another free throw for Taylor.
The New Mexico guy said he was gave a shot fake. Now some pressure from Utah State.
Mathis for three.
Well, he can't buy one.
Merrill stop and start. Now to Brown. His three is good. Lead is 11 with 3:15 to go. And a steal by Brown. Brown all the way, missed it. Out of control shot.
That would have been a big one.
Could have cut it to single digits. And now, New Mexico will use some clock inside three to play. Logwood in the paint. Good defense by Utah State. Now four on the shot clock. McNeil drives right in and scores with the shot clock expiring. McNeil a little shaken up after that bucket. He's holding on to his right hand and appears to be in some pain.
Yeah, that's not good.
Oh, McNeil is hurting as a foul is called. Watch McNeil at the end of this bucket comes down on his right hand.
And it's already wrapped.
That doesn't look good. Left hand to shake hands. That right one has not moved. No.
Well, the trainer's not looking at it.
Oh. bursting her triple team, gets it to Logwood. Simons wisely backs it out. Three on the shot clock. Logwood's three is no good. Long rebound to McEwen. Three on three the other way. McEwen will split the D and score.
Now they're attacking the basket. New Mexico stops scoring.
Down to single digits.
Oh, that could have been a drop.
Yeah, very close. A 9-point New Mexico lead, 140 to go. Paul Weir keeps looking up at that clock.
This is when you're saying to yourself, just move.
And Merrill will foul. Why'd they wait till 10 seconds?
Yeah, that's the thing about that. I mean, I could have understood you fouling earlier, but once it got to 10, there was definitely no reason to foul.
Jackson, a 74% free throw shooter, as Merrill committed his fourth foul. Both teams in the double bonus. One more for Antonio Jackson. For an offensive foul.
Yeah, that's him. He was using that right hand to ward off Kuiper. He's gonna try foul him.
Final minute. And a foul with six on the shot clock. Dwayne Brown just fouled out. Well, here's the matchup for the championship tomorrow. New Mexico and San Diego State. They only met one time. This year, it was January 20th in Albuquerque. We did the game on CBS Sports Network, Steve. And at the half, San Diego State was up by 10. But New Mexico outscored San Diego State 41-27 in the second half. They took control late, and New Mexico won the only matchup between the two teams this year.
One thing that bodes well, though, for San Diego State, they have a lot of ball handlers. And in that game, they only scored 9 points off turnovers, New Mexico, in the game. So that's one of the big things that you're going to look at. I think that San Diego State has multiple ball handlers, is what you need against them, and they have good size. So that's going to be a very, very interesting matchup between the Lobos and the Aztecs.
Antonio Jackson was the star of that game for New Mexico. He had 24 points, including a career-high 6 threes. And Utah State not fouling with 30 seconds to go. Jackson with the icing on the kick.
Two teams that are playing for the championship. What a run at the end of the year for both of them.
Paul Weir in New Mexico will ride a 7-game win streak into the Mountain West Championship game. The Lobos are a win away from the NCAA tournament. 83-68, the final score. And it will be New Mexico and San Diego State for the title. First time since 2014 that the Lobos are in the Mountain West Tournament Championship game. As we update the bracket, the 5-seed San Diego State, the 3-seed New Mexico, One of those two teams is going to the big dance tomorrow. A 6 Eastern time start on CBS with Kevin Harlan, Dan Bonner, and Reggie Miller. Let's go over to Evan Washburn.
Well, Coach, I'm going to start big picture here because the story of this team is starting to become pretty impressive. You start the season 3-8. The last time, or the first time you played Utah State, you had 6 guys that lost the game. And now you find yourself 1 win away of the NCAA tournament. How has this group come together?
It's pretty special, man. They just bought into being a team. They bought into working really hard, not caring who starts, not caring who scores. And those things still matter. So thankfully, they've allowed us to get to this point, and now we'll go have fun in one more game.
You mentioned having fun, and it seems that you've done it up to this point. How have you kept this group from recognizing the moment? How will you do that tomorrow?
We just don't talk about it. We just talk about the next game, trying to get better, working hard every day, and just trying to be the best we can be.
I know you like numbers, so here's one for you. 1 win away from the NCAA tournament. No, a lot of fun to watch and see tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
All right, Evan, great job. Paul Weir and the Lobos with their 19th win of the year. One more puts them in the big dance. For Steve Lapis, Evan Washburn, our entire crew, I'm Andrew Catalan. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Good night from Las Vegas.